Hello everyone, welcome to the TSS. After a long gap, we met again. So, from this class onwards, we will discuss the basic front-end language of the web, friends, that is HTML5. Actually, so many viewers are asking for web development tutorials, friends. So that's why I am doing these tutorials, the web development tutorials, friends. So let us learn from the basics, okay? So from the basics of the web, we will learn systematically, okay? So let's jump into the topic. So with a big bang. Right, so let's discuss about the big picture of www. So World Wide Web, how it works. So how internet works. So this is the big picture. Even though it is an introduction, I'm calling it as a big picture. Why? Because here I had presented each and every layer of the web, friends. Okay, so let us discuss it. That's why I call it as big picture. If you understand this big picture, then you will know where you are working. So in which layer you are working, you will understand. So if you get the big picture, then the path will be clear. The scope of the web development is very clear to you. So in which direction we are going, so in which layer we are presently working, okay, like that. So let us jump into the concept. Say, let's understand what is the web architecture. So all these are very IT jargon terminologies are there. So before going to this all jargons and very technical terms, let me explain all these process with an example, friends. Okay, so examples makes us understand any topic very easily. So you already know, do you know what actually, you know all the processes which I had mentioned here. How I can tell in a couple of minutes. Okay, so in a daily life, you are going to a hotel, no? Right, okay. If you know the processes which are happening in the hotel, then you already know all the criterias, processes mentioned here, okay, all the diagrams, jargons, everything. So all will be cleared in a couple of minutes, friends. So let us analyze the hotel process, friends. Okay, so all of us at the some time or the other, we had gone to the hotel, right? So we are hungry, so we gone to the hotel. So what we will do there? Number one, we go and sit there and we call the server, right? Hey server, please come here. Okay, that is the first step. And then we will tell whatever items we like, right? So for example, take a masala dosa, okay? Or some puri or etc. Whatever we like, we ordered. So a server or a bearer take one masala dosa, like that we ordered. Okay, then that is the first step. And then next step, what server will do? The server goes to the chef, right? Server goes to the chef into the cooking room, right? And he had given the slip, right? So first of all, server takes the order from us, like one masala dosa, and then the server goes to the chef room, cooking room, and he will give the slip to the a chef, right? Okay, this is what happening, right? Okay, then what happens? Then chef will see the slip given by the server. Okay, then what chef will do? Okay, one masala dosa, right? Okay, so then he will took the ingredients to make the masala dosa, some masala, all the necessities, ingredients, they arranged, the chef arranged and they cooked, and then he will give to the server. Then what server will do? Server will put that masala dosa into the plate, and then he will put some chutney and sambar right in a plate, right? In a plate. So next server will come to us with the plate which consists of masala dosa and some chutney like that. Then he will serve us. Okay, so that is the analogy. Actually we are doing it in our daily lives every day, right friends? Okay, so this is what happening here also, right? Now come to the topic, from the hotel analogy to the web architecture. The what are the works which we had seen in our daily lives in the hotel is happening in the web also, friends. Okay, let me explain by comparing each and every step with the hotel, so that all these jargons and these technical terms will be very very clear to you. Okay, so now we will start from left to right. Okay, so now we are the user. Okay, so what we will do, we will sit in front of the computer and we will request the website what we need. Okay, so some www.flipkart.com, right? Okay, so like that we are ordering the server in a hotel, like I want masala dosa, it's equivalent to that. So actually what we will use, we will open up a web browser, Chrome or Firefox we open, right? Okay, so with the help of web browser, we are requesting the page what we want. Okay, which page we want, we will request through the web browser. We open the web browser and then we will type the required website, www.flipkart.com, like it is equivalent to ordering a masala dosa to the server. So then what web browser will do, web browser will contact the web server. Okay, so we are requesting, so this is the starting point. So we had gone, we had opened the web browser and we are talking with the web server, like www.flipkart.com, requesting the web server, right? So like requesting the masala dosa with the server in the hotel, we are requesting a Flipkart site from the web browser to the server. Okay, so the web server took the request from the web browser. Okay, and then what happens, so in the hotel what happens, after taking the request, server will go to the chef. Okay, so that is cooking room, right? So the web server also takes the request from the web browser, and then he took the request, and then it will go to the data layer, right? So this is a cooking room, visualize data layer. So this is a cooking room. Okay, in a couple of minutes I will tell all the layers and the jargons and the technical terms. Let me complete this hotel and web analogy so that you will understand very well. Okay, so the server will took the slip what we had requested, and then it will give to the it will process it and it will give to the chef, and the chef will see what are all the requested demanded items. Okay, so in Flipkart we will demand some, say, one mobile phone, some Apple phone, like that we demanded. Then the web server will go and contact the data layer. So this is the chef. Okay, so then chef will take the data server, database server. This is the chef. So chef will take that request, and then he served what the user requested, say someone Apple iPhone, right? Okay, so he the cost, everything will be served as a response to the request, and then the server took that details and then served means response. Okay, he responded, he served to the web browser. Like the hotel server, after contacting the chef and after taken the masala dosa cooked by chef here, so how that hotel server is doing that, the same thing happening here also, right? So the database server, which what are the details given by the database server, the web server took that and then it presented to the web browser. Like the hotel server presented the masala dosa in a plate, okay, in a plate to the table on which we are sitting. Like that this web server will served to the web browser through what, that is important. So in the hotel analogy, we had plate, the server will took the masala, the prepared masala dosa, and then put it onto the plate, and then he served us, right? So but in the case of a web browser analogy and web server, so in the web server he took the details and he must serve to the web browser. And how it has to serve, so here is where the languages comes into the picture, all the layers languages comes into the picture. So in response he will serve in a page form. In which page form? That means HTML page form. Okay, CSS and JSS also will be there, we will discuss everything. So this is the basic. In a page format, the web server will serve to the web browser. Okay, then the web browser accept this response, and then web browser will decode this HTML, and then on its screen the requested contents of the mobile phone will be shown. So this is the process which is happening behind the screens. We are only seeing the front end part, only the browser screen only we are seeing, but after requesting www.flipkart.com or any other site, this much of process is happening behind the screens, friends. Okay, so like that hotel, right? So all those ingredients preparation by the chef, all those things we won't be able to see in many times, right? So we simply sit there and we are chatting with our friends, but after some time the whatever we are requested items will be come onto the table in a plate, right? So same analogy will be followed in the web architecture also. So now I think you friends had got a preliminary idea of the web, right? Now we will discuss about these buzzwords. Okay, so many times you may hear the full stack web development, front end, back end, so many languages names. So you may hear in these days, but that there are many doubts swirling in your mind, maybe because so many languages are talking about front end, back end, right? So you may not able to understand which language is relevant in which stage, like that. Now after seeing all these web architecture at one place, you will come to know so the relevance of everything. Okay, right, let me start the first word, full stack web. What is full stack web? So you may hear this word full stack web. What is stack? What is full? Okay, so the full stack web means, so it consists of two parts. The first part is front end and the second part is back end, friends. Okay, front end, back end. So the front end is the presentation layer, the user interface, the browser. What we are seeing is called a front end. Simply, in a simple terms, what is called front end means after opening the web browser such as Chrome or IE, Internet Explorer or Firefox, whatever we are seeing on that browser screen, that is called front end, friends. Okay, in a simple terms I am explaining. So that is also called presentation layer. Okay, then it is also called user interface. So all the three terms are one and the same, friends. Okay, many times you may know the term user interface, but somebody will come and he is talking about front end, presentation layer, like that, some other buzzwords. So you actually know it, but he uses a different terminology. Actually the content are the same. Okay, the front end or presentation layer or user interface, all these things are same, friends. Okay, in different contexts different words will be used. So simply, a full stack web development is consists of two parts, that is front end and back end. So in the front end, what consists of a front end? Simply, it is an user interface which we are seeing in the web browser. Okay, right. Then what are all the languages which are used for a user interface? Okay, so we have to see the contents served to us by the web server, right? After opening the web server and clicking typing the www.flipkart.com, the request part is over, then the response will come from the server. Okay, that response, the browser must accept that response and the browser has to display it, display the response. So how it has to display that response? Okay, by using these languages called HTML, CSS, JS. HTML means hypertext markup language, CSS means cascading style sheet, JS means JavaScript. These are the major front end languages which are in use in the front end web development. Okay, so I think you got the idea about the front end, friends. And then we will move to the back end now. So the back end consists of two layers. Okay, one is logic layer and another is data layer. So let's concentrate on logic layer first. So in the logic layer, after what happens is, after receiving the request, the web server, what is the function of the web server, friends? It simply takes the request and serves the response. That's it. Okay, that's it. It doesn't know anything. Okay, like the hotel server analogy only. The hotel server didn't know how to cook, right? He only know take the request. What request? Like a masala dosa, puri, how many, how much, how many people, like that. He will just take his order book and he will just write the order. How many puris, how many masala dosa, right? How many idli, vade, okay? So like that. So he doesn't know the cooking part. Just he know the he know how to take the order, okay? Take the request from the people there, like. So same here also. The web server, what web server knows is, web server took the request from the web server, web browser, right? Okay, the flipkart.com, that is the website we are requesting the web server, okay? So the web server took that request. That is the function of the web server, okay? Then the web server must return the response, okay? Then this is the functionality of the web server, right? Everything is fine, okay, up to now. Then what is this, the yellow box is all about? A very, very important thing: language compilers and interpreters, right? So here I mention it as scripting, right? Okay, so let us again move to the hotel analogy, because at every stage we have to compare with the hotel analogy, friends. Otherwise the understanding may be not that much easy, right? Okay, so what web server know? Web server only know the request, taking the requests and serving the response. Okay, so in the hotel analogy, if four people will go to the hotel and ordered, like four people ordered the same thing, say, let us suppose, say, same masala dosa, okay, they order. What happened? So the person A will tell to the hotel server, hotel bearer, that you please put the chilies more in that one dosa. So the all items are same, but he gave one additional additional add-on. What I want chilies more. Like that, person B told, I want masala less. And then the person C will tell, I want masala more. And person D will tell, I want dosa to be paper like. Right? So all the requests are taken by the web server, and then he doesn't know all these things, just he only written like that. Then he has to hand over that request to the chef, right? So in the intermediate stage, these are the compilers and interpreters are there. So in the web analogy, right? So web server took the request. Okay, in our case, what we are requested in the Flipkart site, we want to see one mobile, right? And then the web server took that request, and then so after that, web server doesn't know what is that mobile, like that. He only took that request, and the web server handovers that request to the compilers and interpreters. Every hosting web servers, web servers are all having modules of compilers and interpreters of the scripting languages of their own. Okay, somebody has Django, we will use Django, or Python, somebody will use PHP, somebody will use ASP, somebody will use JSP. Okay, PHP means hypertext preprocessor, ASP means active server page, which is a Microsoft technology, and JSP is Java server pages, that is a Java technology. JS means JavaScript, it is a modern web development language, friends, and Python. Okay, so somebody actually people of their liking of their application specific, it is specific to the application. Which language will be used in the scripting will depends upon the application, friends, use case, friends. Okay, it's purely use case dependent. Okay, so that request will be given to the language compilers and interpreters which are attached to the web server. So the request will be taken up by the appropriate scripting programming language. Okay, so here we will write the scripts, appropriate scripts. Okay, for appropriate requests. Okay, its mobile is coming. Okay, so the mobile script will run. Okay, so that mobile script will be contacting this database for the mobile and the rates, everything, and then database server will execute the SQL queries in the database to get the mobile details of how much cost, how much RAM, how much process, all these things. Then it will respond to the scripting programming language. Then once again this scripting programming languages will respond to the server, will give that response to the server, handed over that response to the web server, and then finally the web server prepared all these details and then will serve that response to the browser. Okay, this is the logic layer, friends. Okay, logic layer, the business logic layer, this is all the process, the head of the website. Okay, I am telling the head of the website is mainly existed in the logic layer, friends. So this part is simply a presentation, right, and this part is simply a pool of data, so much data is available, but the logic layer is the head. Okay, so the head of the department. Okay, right, so like that. So the head of the website is the logic layer in which so many logics are written. Okay, so the process of writing that logic is called scripting, friends. Okay, so for scripting, depending upon the use case and the application we are going to develop, that scripting languages will depend, friends. Okay, some use cases may prefer PHP, some use cases may prefer ASP, JSP, JS, Python, like that. So and then coming to the data layer, so the data layer, as I just now explaining about the data layer, so it's just a pool of data, okay, stored in a form of rows and columns, right? So in order to request the SQL database, we must and should know SQL or NoSQL, right? So it only understand the SQL language, or if it is a MongoDB, then it will understand NoSQL. Okay, so whatever items we need to run a SQL query. So after running the SQL query, the database server serves the response, okay, the result set, right, the result set to the programming languages, and then the programming languages will return the final page to the web server. So then the web server return that response to the browser, and then what the browser will do, browser will present that web page into the browser screen. Okay, so this much of process is happening, friends. Okay, if you click, if you type any website, and after getting the response for your request, this much process is happening, right? So actually this video is becoming lengthy because I am talking about the big picture, not a simple 5-minute video. In a 5-minute video we can't explain the big picture, friends. So this is the big picture of www, and so after understanding this diagram, you will come to know which technology sits where. Okay, database sits where, and the database languages sits where, what to know. If you want to become a front-end developer, then these languages are relevant to you. And if you want to become back-end developer, then these languages are relevant to you. And if you want to only database administrator, then these languages are relevant to you. SQL, NoSQL, like that. Okay, so if you want to become a full stack web developer, then you need to know all the front end languages, back end languages, database languages, all you should know. Okay, so this is the big picture explanation, friends. Okay, so in the next class we will see the part wise, friends. Okay, part wise we will see. Thank you, friends. Your Sveera signing off. Thank you for listening.